Any advice you want to say maybe to the couple?
Just stay strong and stay positive, and you know, you just be the best person you can be toward each other, and be the best person you can be to yourself, and you should be fine. You look beautiful.
Thanks, Dad.
I don't want to get you dressed dirty.
Love you.
I love you too, sweetie.
I'm getting married today.
Yeah, sure. Are you excited?
Yeah.
Don't cry. Don't mess your makeup up.
Love you.
I love you too, sweetie. More than you'll ever know. You're very beautiful.
I said you were going to be the one to cry.
Not me. That happened at my graduation too.
Yeah.
You look stiffy.
Thank you.
Do you think he's going to cry?
Most definitely.
I'm excited.
How about we take a little photo here of y'all too?
You think I could sit on the tree?
You want me to give her a little push or something? I don't know how you get
your dress is getting dirty.
Are these a picture?
Okay.
Yeah, don't fall out now.
No, I could fix it.
Yeah, we don't need to do no flips.
Did you come around this side?
Might be a little too low.
Oh, I couldn't sit that long, sorry. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You did it. Great. I love you.
I love you too, sweetie.
See when you want me down the aisle.
Yeah.
I'm taking
you?
Yeah, everyone is getting kicked out of your truck. So.
Awesome.
Get out. There's that.
This is my best
friend. Did she say Corey? It is Corey.
Oh, it's another Corey.
Corey, nothing else.
What the heck?
Okay.
It looks like a Christmas tree. Whatever you do, don't cry.
Don't right. He gonna cry. Did you want to join me for a quick picture?
Come on, Dad.
Come on. Come on, Dad.
Come on, Dad.
Come on, Dad.
Come on. Yeah, we really got there. We're trying to get a little different shot.
Do you want me to put a little glass in there? Yeah, go ahead.
There we go. All right. Yeah. How you feeling?
I'm doing good, man. My little baby brother getting married today. It's a special day, and I'm proud of him.
I'm feeling real good. I'm happy for my little brother getting married. Hope he don't cry, but I'm happy for him, though.
Just chill, man. How you feeling?
I'm good. Just finally, this day came. We took about, what, like 7-8 years? I know my sister's been anxiously waiting.
Yeah.
Still locking up. Just glad we finally made it.
I'm totally meeking back at it now. But like Mike said, they've been waiting a long time. But I wanted both of them to finish their college degree, and they did.
Heavenly Father, we come today asking you to bless this service. And we're asking you to bless these two couples and make sure they have a prosperous marriage. In your name, Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Good evening, friends and family. I was instructed to tell everybody that they don't want any cameras out, and so we don't want to take any pictures. We're going to let the photographers do what they do. And when she comes down the aisle, when she passes your aisle, could you stand? It's like you know how they do the wave and all of that. So when they come down, she wants everybody to stand. And we want to certainly grant her wishes today, don't we, Corey?
Yep, we do. We sure do.
I owe y'all a debt of gratitude today because you rescued me from work and I was able to be here with you and to participate in this this monumental day. I'm going to try not to get emotional. My congregation, I'm the pastor of St. Paul's Missionary Baptist Church, and they call me the weeping prophet because I'm always crying. But that just simply means I'm still alive. So we are going to honor their wishes, and we're going to have a good time today. It looks like, for the most part, most of us will be family after the day is over, right? We're gonna make this day a special occasion. Now, I've done a few of these before, y'all, but this is family. So y'all pray for me, and we're going to try to get through this. Holy and happy is the sacred hour when two devoted hearts are bound by the enchanting ties of matrimony. And these precious evidences of purity of heart and contentment of mind for all their future are made more sure when the contracting parties enter this glad time, clad in the comely robes of reverence, humility, and faith, that they may then be blessed of our Heavenly Father, maker of us all, the one who has ordained marriage as the cornerstone of family life and the guarantee of an honorable human society. I want to bring your attention to the fact that both of them have their own vows, and so I will say mine after they say theirs. You get points deducted if you got the paper.
Sorry, I've had it for quite some time.
You caught that plug, didn't you?
Handsome, I love you so much, and I can't believe the day is finally here. The day we have been dreaming of, the day I get to marry my best friend, and the day we become the Whitfields. I have thought about this day and what I would say a lot over the past 6 years. When I sat down to actually write my vows, it immediately became clear how difficult it would be to describe how much you mean to me and how much you've changed my life with only a few minutes. Before you, it was only the idea of love that I knew. Just the idea. But the moment that I met you, it was different. It was real, and it felt so natural. I saw how selfless you were early on when you volunteered to take me back and forth to work when I didn't have a car, even though our work schedules were opposite hours. At the time, we were just friends, but it was during those car rides that I began to fall in love with you. You are one of the brightest, most amazing, and incredible people I know. I am inspired by how driven you are and how you just get things done. I knew you were the one when I shared every detail and secret about my life, but you didn't even flinch or judge me for 1 second. You have helped me navigate some rough waters and kept me on the right path at every turn. You have provided peace and calmness to my life where there was usually anxiety and fear. I fell in love with you long ago for many reasons, but what truly stood you apart from the rest was the way that you loved me. With you, I feel seen, safe, empowered, confident, beautiful, cherished, and valued. There isn't a day that goes by where I don't feel loved by you. Being with you feels like home, and I can't imagine a life without you in it. I vow to always work on my relationship with Jesus, keeping him as the foundation in my life and our marriage, and to encourage you to do the same. I vow to do everything I can in this marriage to make you feel as loved as you make me feel every day, to take on your hopes, goals, dreams, and needs with my own. I vow to support you, to encourage you, and to stand by your side through all the triumphs and challenges that life may bring. I vow to treat you with honesty, love, and respect, to take care of you, to push you, to grow and be the best version of yourself every day. I vow to laugh with you in times of happiness and to comfort you in times of sorrow. I promise to always search for the next adventure with you like Monkey D. Luffy searching for the legendary One Piece treasure. Lastly, I promise to let you believe you are the funnier one in the relationship. Life is fluid and ever-changing. I will cherish every moment we share, from the quiet everyday moments to the extraordinary adventures. I see these vows not as obligations, but as privileges. I don't have to honor and cherish you, I get to. I will forever and always love you for who you were, who you are, and who you will become. You know just how indecisive I can be about any decision I have to make, but if there's anything I've ever been sure of, it is the decision to spend forever with you. I love you.
I love you too. I don't have the paper.
You're in violation. You're in violation. She said she didn't want no phones out.
Sorry, beautiful. It is a blessing to be standing at this altar with you today, for it is written, who finds a wife finds a good thing. I know it was stressful waiting for this beautiful moment. You endured 6 long years, and I would like to say thank you for that. I want you to know it wasn't easy waiting that long, and the reason behind it had nothing to do with your characteristics or quality, but with me being the man you deserve. For you, you look at me with eyes that pierce the soul and has no judgment, and a smile that warms my heart and has no secrets. On this day, before God and all of our family, I vow to love you unconditionally as you are today, tomorrow, and eternity. When the days come when we are old and gray or sickly and wrinkled, I vow to look at you with the same set of eyes as I do on this day. I vow to support you and protect you, to honor you and to respect you. I vow to be your best friend and to never stop pursuing after you. I vow to always stand by your side through this journey of life. I humbly submit myself to you, always and forever.
I mean, what do you say after that? I mean, I just, let me just interject something before I do my vows. As you grow older, you have to go into that understanding that every day you need to try to find something positive about each other. And can I share with you from the outset that some days it's going to be harder than others? The only place that success comes before work is in the dictionary. This is a full-time job, no lunch breaks, no PTO, no vacations, 365 days a year for as long as you live. And I believe that both of you are capable of that. And something completely offset, you need to get a patent for that thing and you could make money off of that. Marriage is an institution of divine appointment and is commended as honorable among all men. It is the most important step in life and should not therefore be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but discreetly and soberly. In this estate, these two persons come now to be joined. If any person present can show cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever hold his peace. I solemnly require and charge you both, as you hope for joy and peace in the marriage state, if either of you know any just cause why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. This is where you just be quiet. Do you, sir, take this woman to be your lawful wife, and do you promise before God and these witnesses to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Do you take this man to be your lawful husband, and do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Are there rings present? Oh, do we? Yes. Okay. No. Okay. All right, Corey, you go first. We know that we put the ring on the left third finger. All right, with this ring, I thee wed. Repeat after me, son.
Sorry, repeat that again.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods, I thee endow.
And with all my worldly goods, I be endow.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Inasmuch as this man and this woman have in the presence of God, and these witnesses consented together to be joined in the lawful bonds of matrimony, and thereto have given and pledged their troth to each other, now you're going to do the same thing for him. And repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods, I thee endow.
And with all my worldly goods,
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Now, inasmuch as this man and this woman have in the presence of God and these witnesses consented together to be joined in the lawful bonds of matrimony, and thereto have given and pledged their troth each to the other, and if the ring has been used, and so what I will do now, by the power that is given to me as a pastor, minister of Texas, I pronounce them husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. I present to you now Mr. and Mrs. Corey Whitfield. Yes.
like a dream to me. There's some other dream. I love tomorrow.
Keep it tight when it turns that night. I'd just like to start by saying good evening, and thank you all for being here to celebrate this joyous occasion with us. Today is a day filled with love, laughter, and memories. It will last a long time. As Alexis' parent, I could hardly put into words the immense pride and happiness I feel standing here. From the moment she was born, she brought light into our lives, and watch her grow into the incredible woman she is today has been one of the greatest blessings. To Corey Whitfield, welcome to our family. Seeing love and joy you bring to our daughter warms our hearts, and we are thrilled to have you in the family. To the newlyweds, as you embark on this beautiful journey together, my wish for you is that your love continues to grow, that you always support one another, and that your home is forever filled with happiness and peace. Please join me and raise a glass to love, laughter, and a lifetime of happiness for the Whitfields.
Hello, I'm Raven. Nice to meet you. to meet you all. Hello, Whitfields. I came up here with no plans of what to say. But they asked me to pray over them and bless them for their marriage. And I was reading my Bible this morning, and I just so happened to come across instructions for Christian households. And I was like, oh, what a day. Yes, very good stuff, Ephesians 5. And I'm going to read it. It says, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, that's you. You're a wife now. Wives, that means Alexis Deanne Whitfield. Submit yourself to your own husbands as you do to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. And Lexi, I have a question for you. Are you ready to submit yourself to your husband?
Wholeheartedly.
Are you sure?
100%. I'm not saying it'll be easy, but I will do my best.
Amen, sister. Amen. And it says, husbands, that's you, Corey, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church. Now, digging into that a little bit, Christ gave himself up for the church. That means that he submitted himself in every way that is humanly possible, and he came from the heavenlies and descended down to the earthly realms, and he came and he laid himself low and died on the cross. And I'm asking you, that are you willing to lay your life down for Lexi?
I do. I will.
Good. So in the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated their own body, but they feed and care for their body just as Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is New Testament, but it's calling on Genesis, the beginning of everything. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. Now, they asked me to pray for this wedding, but I had to ensure that in order for me to pray and to actually really mean it, I had to ask permission, because if you're not willing to do that, then I have nothing for you. But by your profession and by what you both just told me right now, I am now going to bow my head and ask all of you to bow. Father God, I just ask right now, Jesus, that you would come, God, with your hand over the Whitfields right now, God. And Lord, I pray that your spirit would draw them into you further and further than they have ever been before. Lord, I pray that you give Corey the leading and the unction, that power, the drive in order to lead his beautiful bride into a deeper relationship with you, God. And I pray that it would be real. I pray that it would be really real, realer than anything else, realer than the physical. God, I pray, Lord, I just pray over Lexi. I pray for her to be helped in the submission area. And Lord, I pray that you would bless her, and God, give her the wisdom and the strength to carry out the wifely duties that she is assigned. Lord, you've given us roles, and Lord, help them both to fulfill theirs in your church. We love them, and we love you, God, and I just ask, God, that you would come, your spirit would come, and you would bless us all. Bless them also. We love you, Jesus. We praise you, and it's in your holy name we pray. Amen.
This is not Big Daddy. I can see everybody. I know everybody can see me. Oh, he did that. Okay. Perfect. Okay. To my beautiful, smart, loving sister. And it stops. Okay. Girl, me and you have been through so much growing up. And I absolutely wouldn't have wanted to do it. Wouldn't have wanted anyone else to navigate through that with but you. We definitely kept each other sane, and most of all, from smiling. Okay, I can't see, it's blurry. But as I'm sitting here trying to come up with the best moment, a best holiday, a best year, I can't. Because there were so many good moments. Wabang. And then the gibberish talk. Yep. Rewatching movies and all of the crazy chaotic things we would do as children and that carried on into our adulthood, where we talk country to annoy others and still do our gibberish talk, and somehow it seems like we are having an actual conversation. I don't think you truly know how proud I am to be your big sister. Sorry, sister. To get to witness you being and becoming who you are today. You are stable. You are smart. You are driven. Stop it. You, my little sister, went to college paid by you. No one else. You did that while living alone, paying for all of it alone, until, of course, you and Corey moved in together. You got your first big girl vehicle. I was really proud of that one, because I'm sorry about that car I had to give you, girl. You worked a full-time job, each time, each thing amazing me. And now here you are, married to your best friend, your soulmate, your future, your everything. Brother-in-law, you truly are so amazing to my sister. And you have got to have the most patience ever, because I know she can be a lot to handle. That girl used to want to fight me because I couldn't get her hair exactly in the middle of the top of her head. This was an every morning occurrence, by the way. Every morning. Anyways, I love you both. I'm so happy for you guys, and I'm so happy I get to witness y'all becoming one, a unity. I love y'all.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. First of all, I'm Corey's oldest brother, the cute one. And my brother, he took a big step today. He married his best friend. He put his big boy drawers on. And I'm proud of him. And my sister-in-law, I mean, she's been like a sister, even to me. Helped me a lot. And I'm proud of him today. But yeah, that's off topic. Let me read my little thing. That was a little freestyle. Hello everyone and welcome. For those who don't know me, I'm Bud, Corey's oldest brother. And I'm incredibly honored to be here today to celebrate this awesome couple. I heard Corey initially had a hard time choosing his best man. First, he asked his funniest friend, and they said no. Second, he asked his smartest friend. They also told him no. Third, he asked his most handsomest friend. They told him no.
I don't remember him asking me.
All right, Mike. Finally, he called me up. And I said, Corey, I can't tell you no four times. So here I am today. But all jokes aside, I just want to welcome Alexis to the Whitfield family. And the love you two have, it's easily seen how y'all interact and how y'all look at each other. I mean, it's clear as day. And I just want to wish y'all both a lifetime of love and prosperity. So everyone, lift the glasses of your non-alcohol beverage and toast to the Whitfields. Cheers.
We just wanted to thank everyone for coming. It's been such a blessing today, just all of you being here. We really appreciate it, all of the help that we received. You know who you are, and I love you guys so much. I don't think we would have been able to make it here without all of you in some type of way, and I really appreciate y'all being here. I don't know if my husband has anything to say, but...
I would like to say thank you all for coming. Thank you all for all the hard work y'all put in last night to set this up. Y'all did make me work hard. I didn't get enough sleep, so, but it don't matter. But thank y'all for coming. We love y'all.
Furthermore, for me, I just wanted to say among the many relationships we're celebrating today, there's one bond that I would like to take a moment to honor. Dads undoubtedly have their special moments during the wedding, their first look, giving away their little girl, and even a dance dedicated to them. But there's nothing for mom. I want to carve out a special space just for you, mom, for your sleepless nights, your tireless days, and your endless love. Words can scarcely capture the depth of gratitude and love for you. Mothers give unselfishly, expecting nothing in return, from the moment of birth to every milestone thereafter. A mother's touch, her words, her sacrifices, and her love shape us. So tonight, instead of the usual bouquet toss for all the single ladies, I have chosen to dedicate my bouquet to my mom, not as a tradition, but as a heartfelt tribute to the love that she represents. Thank you.
Oh. Thank you. Darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And baby, my heart could still feel less hard at 23. And I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe just the touch of a hand. Well, me, I fall in love with you every single day. And I just wanna tell you I am. So honey, now out loud, maybe we found love right where we are. When my hair's all but gone and my memory fades, and the crowds don't remember my name. When my hands don't play the strings the same way, I know you will still love me the same. Cause honey, your soul could never grow old, it's evergreen. And baby, your smile's forever in my mind and memory. I'm thinking about
come on, guys. I want to just bust the mold.
No! I'm here right now.
Hi, Alexis and Corey. I'm so excited for you guys to finally be married. I'm really happy that I've been a part of your lives for as long as I have. And I look forward to many, many awesome years with you guys. Congratulations.
Oh, y'all ugly. I'm just playing. Y'all know I had to get that in there. But I love y'all guys so much. And I just wanted to say that always remember to keep y'all's relationship like a triangle where God is at the top and y'all two are at the bottom. And the closer y'all get to him, the closer y'all get to each other. I love y'all and I pray that y'all have a beautiful marriage.
Hey, you guys. I love you so much. Congratulations.
Hey, Corey and Lexi. I just want to say congratulations. We are so happy that this day came. We are so excited for you guys to get married. And we just pray God's blessing over your lives. Always remember to love each other. Even when you don't love each other, always choose love. We love you. Have a blessed wedding. Can't wait to see you at this.
Hi, handsome. I can't believe the day is finally here.
I'm going to try to keep my composure, but I'm still so excited to be at Whitfield.
I think the dress is going to be beautiful. I think it's going to be either white or beige. I'm excited for this day. I'm nervous a little bit, but can't wait to make her my wife.